This is a 2014 to 2018 Subaru Forester. Before we get started though, let me give a quick shout out to Mia Max Automotive for letting us use the car today to film the videos. They are a used car dealer here in Toronto, Canada. Check out the link in description for their entire inventory. Now let's go ahead and open the driver's side door. Right by where the driver's left side foot would go, that's where the primary hood release lever is. So pull it. Now in front of the vehicle, right below the Subaru emblem over there, that's where the secondary release lever is. So put one finger in there and push it left. While you're pushing left, lift up the hood and the hood goes up. It goes up and stays in place by itself because of that support rod, the hood strut right over there. Yep, that is good. That's where the front turn signal bulb is, one on each side. That's it. We'll start off with the passenger side first, right? Now that's the bulb. The way to access it is right there behind it. There it is. That's the black bulb holder for it. You can just loosen it, push it down using your finger, loosen it. Twist it left like that. Now it's loose. You can grab the bulb from behind that red bar. Grab it and it'll come off. There's enough play in the wire that you can sort of just get the entire bulb holder and bulb out now. Yep. In order to get the bulb off, all you have to do is just grab it and pull it out. It'll come straight out. And there it is. That's the bulb over there. Let's take a closer look at it. As you can see, there are two filaments inside it for two different functions. Parking light and the turn signal. And the bulb replacement size number is 744NA, 744NA. Get the new bulb and put it in. Simply push it in. It's going to lock it in place. If it doesn't lock in like that, see if you're having trouble like this, all you have to do is pull it out, turn it around, and then push it in. And then it'll click right in. See, that's good. Now let's put the bulb holder back into the light. We're going to get a different view from like the back side now. Get the bulb holder in first the light. Once it goes in there, make sure it's sort of sitting flush. And you see that's sort of like an arrow right there. Yep, that one. It should be at like the 10 o'clock position once it goes in. See, now it goes in sitting flush. Twist your right, lock it in place, and that's done. See, now it's pointing at 12 o'clock. That's pretty much it. Move on to the driver's side one. Again, same process. Loosen it. Get the bulb holder out. Same bulb, same everything. Let's get the bulb off and just verify it. You may have to wiggle the bulb again to get it off, but it should come right off. Yep. Same bulb. Two filaments inside it. One for the parking light function, one for the turn signal function. Same 744NA. Get the bulb, put it in. Again, same issue if you run into that. If it's not going in, just take it out, turn it around, and then push it in. It's going to lock in. Let's put the bulb holder back into the light. Put it in there. Make sure it's sitting flush. Just like that. Yep, see, it's look good. Twist your right to lock it in place, and you are done. That little arrow on the bulb holder is pointing at 12 o'clock. Let's go inside, turn the flashers on, and verify it. See how it looks. All right, now that is looking very good. See how easy the whole process was? Hope you found the video useful. To close the hood, simply lower the hood, push it down, and slam it shut.